make you mop. Charges? I've got
this
a book.
This is my day off.
What's she done this time?
Indecent exposure. Cockfighting. Abusive language. Sign out, if you can.
Thank you.
Light is useless if what it illuminates causes pain and suffering. Better to cast such things into the dark depths of Lethe, the river of forgetfulness.
Thank you. Back to admire your handiwork, returning to the scene of the crime.
It had to be done, Cat. You said so yourself. You and this Red Queen cannot both survive. She is a cancer in your body. Excise her or perish.
Well, she was the face of evil in the heart of darkness.
She didn't treat you too well last time. Lost your head, as I recall.
She was completely deranged. You picked up her crown, but now you've put it down. You must speak to her, what's left of her anyway. Riddle me this. What comes next in the sequence? 1, 3, 4, 7, 11. You never cease to amaze.
The Red Kingdom's in ruins, but you're no better off.
When you defeated her, I tried to reclaim the castle, but I was set upon by her monstrosities. The malignant royal bitch still reigns.
I'm here to petition her. I must get inside.
The only way in is through me. Sacrifices must be made.
Those who say so usually mean they should be made by others.
Cynicism is a disease. It can be cured. Once inside, beware of the outsized killer who patrols her domain. Never confront him. He is invincible. Now cut me loose. I'll show you the meaning of sacrifice.
Games too require hard choices. Unpleasant sacrifices must often be made to accomplish a desired goal.
Tells a story. Wouldn't tolerate a book without pictures when you were a girl.
Bearskin rug before the hearth, no deer antlers on the wall, no taxidermic abominations in the house, demeans the creature's dignity.
Thank you.
I'm an idiot. Don Quixote had a better chance with his windmills, and without risk of decapitation.
Prudent exits no less so for being hasty.
Quixote had a better chance with his windmills, and without risk of decapitation.
A prudent exit is no less so for being hasty.
Weapon's intended function is almost beside the point. Ultimately, it's only as good as the person who wields it.
A locked room is little more than a cage. A prison by another name. I despise concealment of any kind.
She also has eyes for you.
Lovely service. Beautiful music. Closed caskets. Though I'm told your sister could have shown to advantage. The flames never got to her.
Guards of this realm. We are all victims in waiting.
Be afraid now.
She's aimless, shiftless, pointless.
Thank you.
Reflection sometimes exposes more reality than the object it echoes. Thank you.
time to waste. There's no time at all.
Thank you.
a few find the way. Some don't recognize it when they do. Some don't ever want to.
Lizzie hated locked rooms. Her room was further from the fire than mine. Smoke could not have killed her. She never locked her door. And besides, she knew another way out of the house. Out of the window. Someone incapacitated or killed Lizzie. Then locked her door, then took the lamp downstairs and started the fire to cover up their crime. Their plan was to kill us all.
Or insulting talk should never go unchallenged.
world looms large in your dreams, Alice, but cake occupies a special place. Never rejected dessert, I suspect, nor tea if cake was on offer.
Thank you.
You were once two bits of the same psyche. So where does that leave you? Opinions vary. Still, to recover the past, to continue your search, we need to meet with her.
There's no reason to proceed. His hand was slimy, Alice. Like an eel from the Isis. And his name won't help. Bumby, if he ever qualifies, his bedside manner will require improvement.
Excellent.
I was expecting someone else.
You don't know your own mind!
It's nearly a complete stranger.
What you claim not to know is merely what you've denied. You've recaptured your vagrant memories. What are you doing with them? You once rejected my attempts to control our lives forcefully. Now you've allowed another to succeed in my role!
I won't miss your tentacles.
You'd prefer the hot, stinking breath and unyielding attention of a potent, unreasoning, unfeeling Hellraiser? I don't think so.
Can you give me more than a warning? Caterpillar said you might help.
I'd need a better reason to respond than what's currently on offer.
If you don't, we're all doomed.
Not doomed, forgotten. I may survive here, but you're finished. You see the pattern of destruction? I know you do. The train is trying to destroy all evidence of your past, and especially the fire. Now, who would want that? Who benefits from your madness?
The destruction of Wonderland is the destruction of me.
Indeed. And vice versa.
I've set it in motion. I can derail it. This is good for me. I'm not insane. I didn't kill my family. I am fine. I'm not mad. I'm innocent. I mean, not guilty. What's happening? What are you doing?
The train must be stopped. But there's more to do. Your view conceals a tragedy. The whole truth you claim to see eludes you because you won't look at what's around you. There is no method in this madness.
My professional opinion, madness is often a treatable disease, though perhaps not in this case.
Authority must be obeyed, or it must be overthrown.
Cruel to be kind, that's my technique, as they say. But she's as mad as a hatter, poor dearie.
Worst is over, and over, and over. Forget it, Alice. Forget it.
Can't distinguish reality from illusion. Remember your last journey? An elephant never forgets where she left her trunk when traveling by train, a valise, never bigger than your head. I may be wrong, Your Grace, but I doubt it. Down this path of primordial ooze and sideways.
Indeed, Doctor, well demanded, I'm sure. I mean to say, it's very hot in here. I mean to say, fuzzy. And she's no helping. Oh, no help at all!
Humiliation, I say. I approve your release, and back you come like a bad penny. Reputation in ruins, evil talk, Alice. I'm an old dog, ready to bone, don't you know? Loyalty, you must never run away from home. Stay, Alice, sit!